Welcome to FAR, the photographic series. In this series, we are going to guide you through cameras and photographers, their problems, their solutions, and a lot more. Do keep watching. Welcome to another episode of the FAR, the photographic series. So today we are going to talk about what are the equipments required for the different photos of photography. Initially, we will start with the easiest category of photography, that is wedding photography. So what are the equipments that you should invest in if you're looking to be a wedding photographer? So let's start with a basic camera. So when we are doing wedding photography, we do not look at a CMOS camera sensor, we look at a full frame camera sensor, that is a 36mm camera sensor. The point out there is that if you have a full frame camera, you can do a lot more than a CMOS camera sensor. I'll give you examples of that. For wedding photography, we use mostly the Canon series. It'd be the Canon 5D Mark III, the 5D Mark IV that is recently launched, the 6D Mark II, and so on. But they are all full frame cameras. So what are we looking at in this? It is because since we have a full frame, we can use different kind of lenses like the 2405mm, the 50mm with different apertures. We use the 100mm for portraits, the 85mm for portraits. In fact, the Sigma lens series is also a very good choice for this. We use zoom lenses for candid photography in weddings, in which we go use a 70-200. That is at an f2.8, so it gives a good depth of field for the same. The other kind of equipment that you would require along with your camera and lenses are a face light, because a face light is very important in cases where you're in dark zones and where you cannot focus. Secondly, an external flash or a double external flash. What I mean by this is a flash that is mounted on top of your camera or a flash used with a trigger. This is usually done for backlighting or fort lighting, whatever is the necessity at that point of time. In fact, your camera even needs to focus in low light. So for that, you would need an external light source as well. You can shoot at high apertures with lower depth of fields only if you've got the right source of lighting. So lighting is a very important technique that you use in weddings. Especially when you're doing traditional photography, you prefer to use a studio setup. A studio setup is basically two lights, whether it be the Simpex 300 series or the Elechrome 200 series, 400 series or 600 series. It would work for you so that you can take high group pictures, bigger number of group pictures with maybe 15 or 20 people sitting in a group with an aperture of maybe 8 to 10 without any compromise on lighting. So you could set up one of your studio lights out here, one out here, and maybe hit it together with a trigger together, and you would get really good color, vibrant pictures in your wedding photography. Secondly is candid photography, as I spoke about before. So you usually would need an assistant with you when you're doing candid photography, because candid is not easy. You would have to change perhaps multiple lenses. The ideal camera for a candid photographer would be anywhere between a 1DX or a Canon 5D Mark IV would also work fine, because it has higher frame rates. That is, you can on a continuous mode, you can shoot up to 6 to 10 frames per second, which is very important to get the right expression. Another set of lens that you can use is the wide angle lenses, the 16-35 for candid photography. It gives you immense wide angle, which makes the pictures look greater than life. It gives you a king size picture. It makes you feel very, very beautiful. So when you're on a place like a Jaipur palace, or you're anywhere in a Taj, the location looks exotic with those kind of lenses. I would recommend that in case you have the budget for it. But for starters, as I said before, a full frame camera is necessary, a 50mm and a wide angle camera, that is a 2405 maybe a lens would work for the starting. In case you have any questions, any queries, anything that you want to ask us, please do mention it in the comment box below, or you can contact us on info@bxstudio.in. If you like the content of this video, please make sure you like, share and subscribe. Hey friends, This is A.Roshan, your very own house-friendly photographer. We are going to talk about a lot of camera techniques, problems faced by photographers, and a lot more throughout this series. So do keep updated with the Fire series.